How do submarines get oxygen? Remember, unlike ships, the submarine does not have the privilege to ply on the surface and can remain underwater for days at prodigal depths. Now, a primitive question in the minds of many: how does the crew inside a submarine breathe? So, submarines have their means of producing oxygen continuously to help their crew stay underwater for days at a stretch. 1. The environment in submarine. As expected, the inner environment inside a submarine pressure vessel enclosure is far different as compared to the natural so-called open environment. For a typical adult, the rate of air consumption for sustainable living is around 7 liters per minute at a given 21% normal concentration of oxygen. So, per day, the consumption of oxygen amounts to around a whopping 600 liters of oxygen for an average healthy person. For even a small research submarine with a complement of 10 crew, the consumption would be a humongous 600 liters of oxygen per day. Hence, the generation of oxygen for continual supply is one of the major cornerstones for submarine accommodation and systems design. Generation of oxygen in submarines. 1. Electrolysis of water. This is based on the simple chemistry behind the decomposition of water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen respectively. Before the process of electrolysis, desalination is carried out to remove salt content from the water. Two classic techniques are deployed for this. A. Distillation. The oldest and simplest technique, where seawater is boiled off, the water is evaporated as vapor salts are crystallized and removed, and the water vapor is condensed back by calling off the steam through a variety of techniques. B. Reverse osmosis. This is based on the differential concentration techniques where saline water is passed through fine pores of diaphanous membrane-grade substances at calculated high pressures where fresh water is collected at the other side at low pressure and salt content gets trapped as residues. 2. Chemical oxygen concentrator. This is a more advanced, expensive, and risky process but can produce a constant supply in all conditions. So, in submarine technologies, this is often deployed, optimizing the combustible risks and better supply performance. 3. Solid polymer oxygen generator. This technology is increasingly superseding existing conventional electrolytic methods in EOGs as described above. One of the greatest features of this method is the redundancy of using electrolytes like potassium and sodium hydroxides and insulating materials. 4. Removal of carbon dioxide. Here, in submarines, after the generation of oxygen, the removal of harmful carbon dioxide is equally important. The machinery, internal systems, and equipment, as well as the human crew subsisting inside, will produce carbon dioxide gas. 5. Soda lime removal. It is the most popular and inexpensive means of removal used for more than a century, also called carbon trapping. Soda lime is a mix of calcium and sodium hydroxides in water. 6. Using alcohol amines. In this method, the water is bubbled through an aqueous solution of an alcohol amine compound. These are chained organic carbon-based compounds. 7. Lithium hydroxide absorbers. These are used to remove CO2 and the air is passed through the gas canisters holding lithium hydroxide compounds. 8. Burners. Carbon dioxide and other unwanted substances can be removed by forced oxidation methods. 9. Activated carbon. This is one of the easiest and lately popular means of carbon dioxide elimination. Charcoal is a form of carbon and is activated by heating with steam. 10. Emergency means of breathing. In accidents or exigent scenarios, like any other vessel, submarines have an eclectic range of emergency apparatus for their crew before evacuation or resolution of the issue. Please let us know your ideas in comments about oxygen generation techniques. Thanks for watching.